click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have did an expression for the Ostwald Dilution law for the weak electrolyte, and similarly we are going to do the expression for the Ostwald Dilution law for weak acid. So let us understand that how can we derive that expression for a weak acid, the similarly that we have did for the weak electrolyte. So let us do in this lecture.
Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
So in this case we are considering a weak acid, and that is basically I would name it as generally as HA, and which on dissociation it will give that is H plus ion as well as A minus ion. So because it is the one which is basically the weak acid, so that is the reason that an equilibrium will be maintained in this case, and that is what we have represented with a reversible direction over here, as you could see. And the number of moles of the electrolyte that we have took in this case, it was 1 mole of the that is weak acid, and that is the reason that the concentration term, it will be nothing but that is 1 by V, that is moles per dmq. And talking about what is V, actually V is basically the volume of the solution of the electrolyte that or the solution where we could get this equilibrium. So this is the thing that we have to do, and let us start with this one, that is by taking the expression to go in this way, where we have considered that is the HA as the weak acid, which on dissociation it gives that is H plus ion as well as A minus ion. So therefore initially we will get before that is before undergoing dissociation, we will get to know that is the initial moles of that is HA is basically 1. We have taken 1 mole of suppose HA and dissolved in a particular volume of that is unit dm cube, that is 1 dm cube suppose. And so this is what we will get, that is we'll get 1 mole of that is HA that has been introduced, and that is the reason that before dissociation we'll get 0 moles of H plus and 0 moles of A minus. And after dissociation, that is, so therefore after dissociation at equilibrium, then the number of moles that will be left out, it's because we have to understand in this way, where the electrolyte that is, or we could say that is the weak acid, that is 1 mole of weak acid has been dissociated to form that is H plus and A minus, and we could see that it will depend on the degree of dissociation. So therefore if we say that is out of 1 mole of HA, few moles of that is the acid has been dissociated, and that few moles is basically named it as degree of dissociation. So therefore 1 minus alpha has been dissociated, so therefore we could see that is after the dissociation and at equilibrium we could find that is alpha moles of H plus has been dissociated, and similarly we could say that this moles of A minus has been dissociated. And so this is what we could get at equilibrium. But talking about next, that is what would be the concentration of this kind of species that we have that we will obtain in equilibrium. So therefore we could say that is the concentration in terms of that is moles per dmq. So therefore we know that is if this is the number of moles that we get at equilibrium, then divided by the volume, then we'll get the concentration. So therefore we could say that is 1 minus alpha divided by V will be the concentration of HA, alpha divided by V will be the concentration of H plus, and alpha or the degree of dissociation divided by V will be basically the concentration of A minus. So this is what we have got over here, and similarly we are going to apply the that is law of mass action in this case, and for which we will get to know that is after applying the law of mass action, and because we are applying the law of mass action for the weak acid, and this is the term that we have did in our previous lecture also, so therefore we will name this as Ka, that is for weak acid. And that will be nothing but the concentration of that is H plus into concentration of that is A minus to the overall that is HA. So this is what we have got to know, and the only thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the values over here like this one that we have, and let us substitute the values. So therefore we could get that is in this case we'll get alpha divided by V, and again in this case we'll get alpha divided by V, and the whole divided by that is 1 minus alpha divided by V. So if we arrange this thing, then we will get a value which is that is alpha square divided by V square into basically we will write over here as V divided by 1 minus alpha. So this is the very similar thing that we have did in our previous lecture. previous lecture. And the only thing that we have to do is we have to cancel out this thing. And this is the expression that we could get. And that is basically the dissociation constant, that is Ka, is equals to basically alpha square divided by V, which is 1 minus alpha, which is basically the product that we get, that is V into 1 minus alpha. But since it is a weak acid, and we will get to know that is the alpha is very, very much smaller than the one. So therefore, we could say that is for weak acid, that is alpha is very, very much less than one. So therefore, we could say that is 1 minus alpha is approximately 1. So therefore, we could say that is Ka is equals to alpha square divided by. So that's it we have got over here, and we could give the expression in this following way. So we could write that is the degree of dissociation as alpha square, which is equals to basically Ka into V. So therefore, we could say that is the expression can be written in this way, where the alpha or the degree of dissociation is the square root of basically Ka into V. So this is what we have got over here, and this is the expression that we have made for the relationship between that is the degree of dissociation and the equilibrium constant. So this is what we have got over here. But this is not the only thing that we have to do, and let me introduce one more expression. And in this one, that is in the previous one that we have did over here. So if you observe, that is we could write this expression as 1 upon V also in this way. But 1 upon V is nothing but the concentration. So therefore, we could write this expression as Ka is equals to alpha square into concentration. So therefore, we could write it as alpha square is equals to basically Ka, that is the degree of that is the dissociation constant of the weak acid divided by C. So in this case, suppose if we observe, then we'll get to know that is the alpha or the degree of dissociation is basically is inversely proportional to that is the square root of the concentration of the solution. So again, this is the thing that we have got to know over here. So that's it, and yes, we have derived an expression for that is Ostwald dilution law for the weak acid, and which is this one. So thank you friends for watching this video, and I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly, and you share this video with friends, and yes, I hope you will subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.